just listened at like an old man poetry.
Yeah.
Like a rhythm and the voices. But that's like about a man. I mostly understood, but it's like shocks when it's loud sound.
I think it was interesting, very complex. I like it. Yeah, it sounds like maybe just thinking what he said about the description of his life or some story. It sounds like a story where he's presenting it. But it sounds like it's broken up, so the words aren't in the right order.
Understand much of it. He was saying something about first that he has three kids, then something about that he didn't want to go to the army, and something about that when he was young there were two schools, one was Russian and one was German, and I didn't understand much. Yeah.
Ükski kummalgi neist. Okay, it was that. Very old man, first, and then there was two men, also very old, but the common thing, what they were similar about, was that they have a problem with army. I don't know. Great.
He was telling what he can remember. And I think the most important thing was that he haven't been in Soviet army, and it was very important for him. And there was other memories too, but it seemed to me that they were not so important anymore. That he have had accomplished his mission after he haven't been in army, in Soviet army. So he was very lucky about it. I think he is a very proud man.
French, la mer. Mix.
No.
Scramble. Scramble. No, no scramble.
Little trap on near the border, near Russian border. It's Estonian.
No.
The best phrase was
I was not in the German army nor Russian army, but I was still in Russian army.
It was the best phrase, I think.
There were some place names for a bit, and then there was talking something about money. Old Vana in the Met said, old people. Then he asked if you speak Estonian.
One sentence, I could pay the 30 crowns for a month for working. But mostly it was it wasn't possible to make a sense of this speech.
Still in a language, but I couldn't understand the meaning. An old man, in one sentence, he said he didn't go to army, then he said he was an officer, and and he went to Russian school or something, and he lives near the border. Russian border. And then I guess his wife said something. I couldn't understand anything.
There is an old house somewhere near, and someone lives there. And then I heard the word drunk, or I don't know who was drunk, and it was all mixed up like that. Yes, it's hard, isn't it? Hard to understand when there is no meaning behind, or no. Whole meaning in the sentence, and you can't understand the thoughts, they're just words. Mm-hmm. You're trying to catch something. Yeah. interesting. Thank you. Mm.